this person's, this Crow Indian's last name is Burden Ground. I'm not going to give you the first name, but just to protect his identity. But he's a Crow Indian from the Crow Reservation over near Harding, Montana. And that's right next to the Custer Battlefield, by the way. And by the way, if you've never been to the Custer Battlefield, holy crap, that is a trip worth taking.
Time to play with some clay.
There's a great movie on Netflix right now, just started playing around the 1st of November, titled The King. In it, they decapitate a traitor, or whatever you want to call it, and usually the camera cuts away from something like that, but not this movie. This movie showed his head being popped off and dropped down. Well, I'm going to pop off and drop down this head in about 10 seconds here. There we go. Now, I'm not going to destroy this head because I can always improve on it later on. So I'm going to put this someplace where it won't be damaged. I'm going to heat up the wire that holds the head so that it goes into the clay easier. I'm gonna try different angles first before I solidify. Make sure that head's properly positioned on his body. So it needs to come over just a little bit. Sure didn't damage the ears. The thing is, you got to make the design of what you're working on look good from every angle. He's looking in this direction here. That's why his head going that way wouldn't have worked. But that looks good right there. Push his head back just a little bit. The old headdress out of the way. I don't want to go too extreme on the head positioning, but it's got to be balanced. Another good reason to do the head separate from the body so that you can position it once you get it on. I just heard the camera click. That indicates that the camera turned off. Yeah, I was right. So I need to make the musculature on this side of his back a lot more accurate if I'm going to put a blanket over him. Now, if he'd have been leaning against that rock and just sitting down on the side of the mountain here, I don't think he'd have his weapon on him. Yeah, I don't think he'd have a bow and quiver because that would be uncomfortable. Another thing I could do is I could have him holding his bow and quiver. I'd like to put a war club in this hand. This is exciting now. The story is starting to form in my head as I look at it. I'm going to run a center line from his chin and down to the center of his breastbone. I like the shape of that shoulder right there. I want to work on the muscles in this arm a little bit, the shoulder just a little bit more. Okay, I'm plotting out the hair now. I ran a center line from behind his ear, which in the photograph is where the part between the hair is and the front. And go straight over and behind the other ear and down the center of his head. I don't think you can see it, but I'm trying to decide how I want to block in the hair right now, the long hair. And taking some clay and I'm flattening it out with a piece of round wood. I could probably be better off using a pastry rolling pin, but that's what I got. Let's see, give me a knife. Yeah. this is the long, loose hair that he's going to have in the back of his head. I'll put more detail into the hair. Next. Right now, just working out the design of the hair. To be a sculptor, you have to be a hair designer as well. Because if the hair doesn't work with the movement, the piece falls apart. And the whole design has got to be workable as far as casting goes. I know I talk about casting a lot, but you got to think about it, because if you make it difficult for the mold maker to make a mold, and you're making it more expensive to sell your work. Now I gotta fill in behind there. Try out an idea real quick. I gotta tell you, I'm really excited about this piece right now. Because if I can do what I see in my head, it'll be great. If I don't do what's in my head, not so great. Thinking about putting the robe under tension coming up over his shoulder here and up here, coming down here across his chest and into his hand there, and that way I get some nice wrinkles there, and then maybe have an eagle feather hanging out from under the blanket. I don't know if that would work with that hairstyle though. That I have to think about. Doing right now, just setting up the stage for the story. You have to be a set designer too. Being a sculptor is many things. As soon as you realize that, things go a lot easier. That design works too. I hate to cover up those beautiful arms, but do I have to cover up the arms? I have to cover up this that arm for sure. Too happy with that, but at least I got the shape under it, the blanket. Again, I'm just sketching it in. What my mind is seeing. Yeah, I could have the blanket coming across the shoulder like that. His arm like that. Draping down there like that. It complements the face. Yeah, this is going to be the design I'm going to do. I'm not going to do it the way I originally intended. Because I like everything that's going on. I'm going to have to rough up these feathers a little bit because they were underneath the blanket. That's not a big deal. Increase the length of the bow a little bit. Change the angle of his hand a little bit too. Work the robe around his thumb. Oh yeah. I'm liking this. Good face, good movement. I'm gonna start filling in underneath here. Yeah, that's going to be it. I got to quit. As much as I like working on it. Now tomorrow, I won't be here. I might be here late, but it won't be here early. Because I need to go and get some all-season tires on my van so I can drive in winter. My tires are about 8 years old. It's time to change them. And it's getting dangerous to drive in the winter time, so I gotta look out for my safety here. I just don't want to quit, but I got it. He's on watch over his village or his war party. He's seen something off in the distance that doesn't look good, or he hasn't figured out what it is yet. Good night, everybody. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.